Hello and welcome back to our channel Nursery to Varsity. So the today's topic is JavaScript condition, switch, for loop and while loop. This video is going to be a very simple video because we have already studied the loops, switches, for loops and conditional statements in other languages also like C, C++, Python. Or if you have not studied, no problem, we are going to dive in and learn a very easy part of the JavaScript. Okay, so let's get started with the first topic, that is the JavaScript conditional statement. What is the conditional statements? Sometimes there is a condition when we want that we should satisfy either this condition or satisfy the another condition. Okay, so how can we choose one of them? There are the many different ways in which we can choose them to perform the different action which are based on the different conditions. These conditions can be if, else, else if and switch. Okay, so let's have a look at the first one, if condition. What is if condition? If block is executed when the condition inside it are true. How can we write that? The syntax is very simple. What you have to do, just write if and in bracket a particular condition, and if that condition is true, then that statements will be executed. Means whatever the condition you are going to write in those brackets, if they are true, then only the statements will be executed. Okay, there is a flow chart on the right hand side, as you can see that on the screen. So in this don't have a look at if the condition is false. Just go down in the vertical manner. What you will see that condition. If the condition is true, then the conditional code and then the output. This the false part is for when we have the else condition. What is that? If the else block is only executed when the if condition is not true. How can you write the syntax? The syntax is very simple and similar. That is if condition executed and when the condition is true. Okay, so what you have done, if you have given any condition in the if block and that condition fails to execute, then this else part will be executed, and in that else part, whatever the statements you have written will be executed. Now one thing is that the indentation is very important. Why? Because it makes your code more simpler, easier to understand by another person. Okay. So if you have only one statement in the if block, these brackets are not compulsory. These curly brackets are not compulsory. Okay. But if you have more than one statement, always use the curly braces. Okay. Let's have a look at the code for the better understanding of this, what we can say that these all syntax. Okay. Let me open that. See. Let's have a look at the first if statement. What I have done, I have given it a heading, and in the script I have used a variable with the age is equals to 20, and I have written that if age is greater than 18, then write on the screen correct. This B is for the bold. Okay, now what in this goes on, you have passed the value of the variable age as 20. So whenever we will start the loop, if and in brackets, this age will replace by 20, and it will see that the 20 is greater than 18. That's true. Okay, so the output would be document.write, means it will be written on the screen with the correct. Okay, there is no else statement. Now if you have written here 15, nothing will be executed, but as we have written here 20, we will get the output that is correct. See, as you can see that if statement and correct. Let's have a look at the another one, that is if else. Now in this I have passed the value 15, and when I have passed this value 15, I have written there with the else block. Okay, in else block what I have written, if a is greater than 18, that is in if the a condition, if condition, in if condition I have passed out 15 is greater than 18. That's not true, that's false. So we will jump to the else block, and in this it is written document.write, and if this condition does not satisfy. Okay, let's have a look at the output. See, if else statement does not satisfy. In this manner, if and if else work. So now I guess this flowchart is clearly understandable. If the condition is false, we will get out of this block. If you don't have any conditions and if there are some statements inside it, that will be executed. Okay. Now next one is else if statement. What's that? This means that if you have applied if and you have passed out any condition in that and that does not satisfy, then you have again used the else. And in else, you have written that if this condition execute this part, other else switch some three numbers. How can you do that? You can easily do that with the help of the else if statement. You have to just write if and you will pass out the some conditions. Then again else if, you will find out the second number, and in else you will write that if does not match, you can print the result. Let's have a look at the code. How can we do that? See, in this I have written else if statement script type. Okay, leave that. Okay, workbook. I have written here a variable book. What's that? In variable book, I have passed out the signs. Now I have written here if book is equals to history. This string will be equal. We have studied this double equal to and triple equal to in the previous video. You can have a look at this previous video and understand if you are not clear with this point. Okay. Now, whenever I will pass the book variable, means the signs will be passed. Okay. And if it's not true, then it will jump to the next else if. Again, this is not true. Again, it will jump to the next else if. Again, this is not true. And then the last was that unknown book. Okay, let's have a look at the output. See, unknown book, because we have passed the variable signs and it does not match any of the condition with the if. So we will pass out, and in the last I have written this unknown book, and this that will get printed. Okay, next one is switch statement. So whenever we talk about the else if statement, if there are 5 to 7 conditions, and if you are more clear to use else if, then use that. But if there are more than 10 conditions, it is mainly preferable to use a switch statement, because it makes your code easy to write, because it makes more understandable and does not make you confuse between the different else if. Okay, so what's a switch statement? First of all, we will see that what is the syntax. Okay, in syntax, first of all, you will write the keyword switch. Okay, and you will pass out a particular expression. Now you will pass out the different cases. I have written case x, case y, default. This case can be any number of cases, does not matter. And in every case, you will write the statement, whatever the statement you want to pass. And after that, you will write the break statement. What's the use of this break? We will see that. Okay, let's have a look first at this flowchart. I have passed the expression. Okay, it will check with the case first. If it matches the case first value, then the code block 1 will be executed. If it does not, it will go to the case 2. Again, does not, case 3. And if all the cases are finished and it does not match with any of the case, it will go to the last case, that is the default one. Okay, so there are some points that are need to be remembered when we talk about the switch statement. These are, first, always remember that the switch expression is always evaluated once. The value of the expression is compared with the values of each case. Okay, in case x, case y, as we have written, that x will be compared with the expression value. Okay, and if we found a match, the associated block will be executed. Now, the use of the break statement indicates that the end of a particular case. If you do not use that, the interpreter would continue executing each statement in each of the cases. Okay, let's have a look at the code. See. Switch statement, I have passed out. If you want to find out, this is an example of a particular marks. In this, if you have find out some marks and you want to find out the grade, what you can do that? I have not written that numbering part. You can do it by yourself. Okay, that's not the main topic. The main topic is how to use a switch case. Okay, so you have to write the switch keyword, and in the brackets you will write that particular expression you want to find it out. Okay, and I have already declared that variable c. Okay, now see case. Okay, and after the case you have written a, b, c. This grade, whatever the value will be passed to this grade, will be matched with this value. Okay, in this way the switch works. Now what we have passed, the value c. So what will be the output? The output would be document.write passed. Okay, if you pass out d, it will not so good. Case f, fail. And if it does not match any of the block, it will print unknown grade. Okay, and the last word I have written, exiting switch block. Let's have a look at the output of this. See, entering switch block passed, exiting switch block. Okay, so in this manner the switch works, and it's very good to use the switch when we have a large number of the cases. Now let's understand the very important loop, that is the for loop. The for loop is mainly used when we want to execute any number of the block multiple times. Let's take an example. You want to print your number name or any number 100 times. What you will do? You will write every time? No, not at all. Who is going to waste that much of time? What we will do, we will use the loop. How can you use the loop? For this, it's very simple. There are the different type of the loops. These are for loop, while loop and do while loop. What are the difference between them? Let's have a look. So the for loop is used when we want to execute any block multiple number of times. Okay, so the syntax is very easy. In for loop, I have passed the first statement as initialization, second is test condition, and third is the iteration statement. And in brackets, I have written some statements that will be executed. We will understand the syntax with the help of the code. First, have a look at this flowchart. Okay, first of all, we will use the initialization. We will initialize that. If that condition is false, the loop will be break and we are out of this. If that condition is true, then the statement, that is the conditional statement, would be executed, and then we will move to the iteration statement. Okay, so first one is initialization. It will set a variable. Okay, it is optional, remember that. Conditional, it is also optional. It defines the condition. If it written true, then the loop means then the condition will be executed. If not, we will out of that. Third one is iteration. Iteration means you will move to the next part. It will increase the value. It is also optional. If you will not use it, that does not make you any problem. Okay, let's have a look at the code. For loop, I have declared a variable. We have written here, we are going into the loop, starting loop. Okay, first one is initialization. I have initialized the I with zero value. Okay, what I have done? Pass out the condition, that is I is less than 10. Until and unless this condition is satisfying, we are going to execute these statements. Okay, and when this condition would be fulfilled, we are out of this loop. Okay, so how would be the procedure? First, this only take place one time, only executed once. Now this I is means initialized with a zero. We will not get back to this I is equal to zero again. Now what will happen? We will check this I with the 10. Is 0 less than 10? True. Okay, so let's get into the statements that are written inside the for loop. These are document.write current count, that is I, and the value would be printed, that is current count 1, current count 2, current count 3. Until when? Okay, now what will happen? When the document.write will print current count, first one is 0. After printing the statement, there are no further statement. This is the break statement that would be printed. And after, as it will reach there, but before reaching there, it will get back to this I++. Okay, and again this value of I, further before it was 0. Now it will get incremented by 1. Okay. Now we will compare it with again. Okay, so this loop will continue to execute until when? It will stop when I reaches to 11. Why? 11 less than 10. Is it true? No. Is it false? So, at that time, this loop will break. And when this loop will be break, we will stop it and no further execution take place and this value will get printed. Okay, let's have a look at the output. See, current count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and yes, 10 will not get printed. Why? That's so simple because I have not used the equal to sign. If I have used the equal to sign, then only the 10 will get printed. Okay. Now, let's have a look at the while loop. Let's first understand the syntax of the while loop. See, the while loops through a block of the code as long as the condition is true. In this, what we will do, we will initialize the variable in the starting value. Okay, in the starting, we will initialize it with a particular value. And after that, we will pass out a condition. If that condition is true, then the particular code get executed. Let's have a look at this flowchart. See, while condition, conditional code. See, in this, we will first check out the condition. If the condition is true, then the code block will be executed and we will get back to the condition again and again if there is an increment in that particular value. Okay, but if the condition is false, then we will move out. Okay, so let's have a look at the code to have a more clear understanding of this. See, you will declare the value. This is normally used for printing. Okay, see. Now we will pass out the condition, that is the 0 is less than 10, right? So it will print it out. Okay, and again this value get incremented by 1. So now again this condition will be checked. This condition will be checked and checked until this condition gets false. If we get the 10, 10 is less than 10, we have not used the equal to sign, means that we will get out of the loop and we will get printed by this. Let's have a look at the output. See, same, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and loop stopped. In this way, the while loop works. So what's the difference between do while loop? In do while loop, it is just similar to the while loop, except that the condition check happens at the end of the loop, means that whatever the statement you have written out inside the do will be once will be get executed and after that the condition will be checked. Whatever you have written inside the do will get printed, then only the condition will be checked. Okay, so what's the syntax? Do, statement, while and expression. See, this is a flowchart on the right side on the screen. Code block, you get into the directly get into the code. After that code, that condition will be checked. Means code will get executed. Then the condition will be checked. If the condition would be false, we will come out of the loop. And if condition is true, then the loop get again executed. Let's have a look at the code. See, do while loop, I have initialized with the variable C, this document.write, and we get into the do loop. What it will do? It will first print out document.write C. Means 0 will get printed. Now what will happen? We have increased the loop, that is from C0 it will get incremented to 1. Now the condition will be checked, means start of the loop, that is current count 0 will get printed. Now 0 is less than 5, right? So this condition is true and then we again back into this. So what will happen? The output would be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. In this manner, the loop, means the do while loop, works. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And also you can like us to all our pages and the link to the pages is given in the description below. Thank you.